What are some of the common injuries you hear of? Like in the, I know you've been working out for years. Mm. What are some of the common injuries you hear people deal with, or at least not even injuries, or maybe injuries, or even certain things people might complain about within the calisthenic world?
I must admit, when it comes to calisthenics, it's very upper body dominant. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, push-ups, muscle-ups, dips, yeah. Pull-ups. Not to say you can't do squats, not to say you can't do lunges. But, you know, it is what it is. A lot of guys, you know, work on their upper body more than their lower body. It depends mm-hmm. on the individual.
Yeah.
But wrist injuries, which I suffered from wrist injuries, shoulder pain, I don't know nobody with chest pain, but it's a lot of shoulder pain, especially when you're working with your rotator cuff, if you do a lot of muscle ups, wrist pain, neck pain, and that stems from not implementing proper stretching techniques and proper warm-up techniques.
Gotcha.
And as I've gotten, and as I'm getting older, because nobody's getting younger, we all get older.
Yeah, we all getting older, yeah.
You have to really start to implement proper stretching, mm-hmm. proper warm-ups, because it will catch up to you.
Absolutely.
And I pride myself on warming up, so I'll probably do some, you know, some wrist arounds and things like that. I'll probably do some, before you even work out, focus on dynamic warm-ups. So I always try to do dynamic warm-ups. If I have a resistance band, I do some over and unders so I can make sure that my shoulders have some mobility.
Gotcha.
So it's just little things like that. As you educate yourself, you know, you just don't get into the workout just like that. Just jump mm-hmm. in. You know, that's mm-hmm. how you really injure yourself, man. You got to really warm up and you got to really tune the body into what it's about to go into, mm-hmm. per se.
Yeah.
So, yeah, a lot of wrist injuries, a lot of shoulder impingement, gotcha. Things like that.
So you feel like let me not say cure, but the way to prevent things like happening is by implementing a great warm-up before you begin to work out.
And not just before you work out, try to implement some yoga. Yoga is amazing. Try to implement some yoga. Just try to implement some mobility work overall. Even if you're not working out, on the days that you're resting, you know, just don't rest and just eat food and things like that. Yeah, that's awesome. But also implement some type of mobility work that's going to help you to be mobile. Gotcha. All right? That's going to help you to perform exercises more efficiently, more better. Mm-hmm. Have that better mind-to-muscle connection. They always talk about things like that. But mobility is one of the best things that you can do for your body.
Gotcha.
No matter if you're a calisthenic athlete, no matter if you're a weightlifter, no matter if you're a martial artist, mobility is key.
Gotcha. So even on, like what you're saying is, even on your rest days, you should be stretching. Or
yes.
Gotcha. So every day you should be stretching. How, for someone, a rookie, someone who's new to this, how often would you say they should be stretching? Morning, night? Once a day, twice a day? How often?
Once a day, twice a day is fine. You don't have to go too crazy. I find that when I stretch before I go to sleep, mm-hmm. I sleep much better.
Okay, your muscles are relaxed.
I'm relaxed.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So that's why, like, after the workout, after intense workout of you know, breaking down multiple muscle fibers and tissues and things like that, you want to have that recovery aspect of it. Now, how do you recover? By stretching.
Yeah.
Adding, there's multiple different types of stretching, but two primary. You have dynamic, which is more movement.
Yeah.
Mobility-wise. Then you have static, which is you're just holding. You're in an isometric state.
Gotcha.
So a great example would be if you're doing a downward facing dog in a yoga pose and you're just holding it right there. Mm-hmm. So that would be more of a static stretch.
Gotcha.
Or if you're just you're on the floor and you want to touch your toes or things like that. Or if you're standing and you're touching your toes and you're just holding it, static.
Mm-hmm. Static.
So, yeah.
Got you. My brother played football, and he would always be like, you know, he would get upset when he see like football players or whatever, let's say you're about to do football, basketball, whatever the case,
yeah.
He would get upset when coaches would make the players do static stretches before. Are you supposed to do static stretches before or after the workout?
Oh, you know, it's very subjective.
Okay.
It's very subjective. A lot of people have different thoughts and opinions on that.
Mm.
For me personally,
yeah,
I've learned that dynamic warm-ups work better with me before I work out. I wouldn't try to like really like static stretch so much.
Yeah.
You could add into it, but I wouldn't like increase the duration of the static stretch.
Gotcha.
No more than 10 seconds in a position if I'm about to work out, you know, because you want to be fluid, you want, yes, the blood to keep flowing. And you want to get fired up. So yeah. I always tell people that the dynamic warm-up, the warm-up itself is for you to prepare your body for the stimulus ahead.
Okay. Got you. So I guess if I'm hearing you correct, it's subjective, as you said. Yes. However, for you, it's more so dynamic stretches, get to working out. After static stretches, relax, yes, you know, relax the muscles or whatever the case may be.
Yeah.
Gotcha. I bet.